Hi guys, so I wanted to show you my last toy I received from eBay. So as I am fed up of taking apart consumer grade equipment, I started to look for laboratory and medical stuff. And my first score is this thing. So as you can see, there is science in it. So, be careful with it. What do we have here? We have Datax Catnomac Anesthesia Monitor. So it is a device that monitors the mixture of gases during anesthesia and also monitors the breath of a patient. So it seems quite old. I believe it is from the mid 90s. I hope to find dead codes inside. So we have one air input here with a water trap, quite a neat LED display and some keys. So as you can see, it measures O2, N2O, CO2, and the anesthesia gas mixture. It works with three anesthesia gases: halothane, enflurane, and isoflurane. So I believe the problem must be, I got it on eBay for parts for 50 euros as non-working. It seems to be a problem with the N2O measurement because it never measures any N2O. But the audio measurement seems quite right. So here is the front panel of it. Here at the bottom you have three layers of instructions that slides they are plastic kits and quite neat. Sadly, it is written in German, so it does not help very much. On the rear side, there is not much, in fact, just a fan, some air outlets, a printer port, a buzzer, IOC port plug with medical grade with two fuses, main switch, and a big grounding port here, on the manufacturer plate. So it is made by Datax Instrumentarium Corp in Helsinki, Finland. So it is quite neat. As you can see, there is only one printer output, so it seems it is not made to be connected to a bigger system, because now the anesthesia machines contain the whole system with a breather pump, anesthesia evaporator, and things like this, and even electrocardiograms. So it seems this one is an old device and it does only monitor the breath of the patient. So I will now turn it on and try to make you a little demo of it. Okay, so the mains is connected. I did connect a little tube to blow in the thing, so I turn it on. You can see the nice LED displays. Now it is doing some boot procedure where it is initializing the instruments inside. It seems to have two small spectrophotometers, in fact, very, very nice. So it takes a few seconds to initialize. It should be almost good. Not yet. Okay, so we are good. So I disable the alarm because it is making noise, if not. So you can see the audio number here seems about right. It is believed to be 21% of air, so it should be right. I activate the other displays. I can activate a gas measuring. So now, as you can see, it is written, it is in, I am in apnoe, because I do not blow in the thing. So as you can see, when I blow, it starts measure CO2 concentration. And this level here does light up. I can do this. It will show the two alarm levels, low and high. So as you can see, it now gives my number of respirations per minute. Percentage of O2, difference between inspiration and expiration. So the way it works, it is quite strange, because in fact, this tube is, this air input is so small, it does just measure air pressure difference and a very low air flow in this tube. I do not know the original pickup tube for it, the size. I believe it is a pickup tube that is derived directly onto the anesthesia mask. Not sure. So it is again an alarm. So as you can see, it did never measure the N2O. And of course, these numbers are at zero. But the other things seem to work, as far as I can tell. So if I press this button, it will reset. And it is doing its boot process again. So these keys are for setting the alarm levels. And there is a calibration procedure for it, but it requires a calibrated gas to do it, a can of gas, so I cannot do it anyway. Okay, so thanks for watching. In I will show you in the next video the factory where it was made in Google Earth, because the factory is still existing. Thanks for watching. Bye bye.